Vice President, thank you.
Well, it's a pleasure to see you all again. Much has happened since we last met, and I'm looking forward to reviewing developments with all of you. We have much to thank you for. Political and military pressure you've applied, I think, is showing results. The Sandinistas have now signed a peace agreement based on democracy in Nicaragua. We'll be watching carefully to see if they really comply. Without the freedom fighters, they will have no incentives to implement the measures they've said that they will implement. We have not yet decided on the format of our next funding request, but we intend to see that you have adequate funding until a ceasefire is in place and the verifiable process of democratization is underway.
Lights, please.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. President, are you aware of the situation in the Philippines? There's currently been a mutiny against President Aquino.
I have just heard word of that and have no further details on it.
Are you going to go for this escrow account idea for contra funding, sir?
We're going to have a meeting here, and they will be holding a press conference later, and we'll be issuing a statement.
But you're not going to let them die, are you? You're not going to let the movement die?
No.
How are your allies?
Thank you.
How are your allergies, sir?
You must be able to, hear it. I'm not my usual high tenor.
Let's go, please.
Come
thank
on.
You.
Let's go.
Go ahead. Well, it is good to see you all again, and I very much wanted to meet with you to review where we are. I want to start by reaffirming that my commitment to your cause is as strong as it ever has been. And we're actively examining how best to continue providing that support. As you know, we have an agreement with Speaker Wright that we will not send up a funding request until September 30th. We intend to see that you have adequate funding until a ceasefire is in place and a verifiable process of democratization underway. But I feel strongly that the Guatemala agreements are an historic document that was made possible by the military and political pressure that you've been applying. As for the agreements to work, that means genuine actions from the Sandinistas on democratization. They have to know that this pressure is still there and will remain if they don't implement or comply. The agreements do not seem to have any sanctions for a non-compliance. And the freedom fighters are the sanctions, like you always have been. Colonel Bermudez, I'd like to take advantage of your presence here to commend you for the Campesina Army, which you lead, for the steadfastness you've exhibited over the years. And I would appreciate your passing on to them from me my appreciation and support. Tell them they've not been abandoned. And if the Sandinistas are serious, the battle is won. If they're faking or trying to stall, we'll know that too. And we will not let them get away with a fake democracy. Take my word for it. You've made great progress on human rights, and it's important to keep working on this. And I'm interested in hearing what the military situation will be over the next 10 weeks or so. And I hope you'll continue working closely together with each other and with us. This is an excellent opportunity for all of you to gain the perception that you are the real democratic alternative to the Sandinistas. We have to keep their feet to the fire. If everything goes right, we should all be in a much stronger position. Now I'd rather listen and talk.